So, let's fix the issue we have with our weapon. Not being jittery when we bring the aim down sight position. And we're also going to add a few more things to that. So, let's bring this back. Okay, let's run the game again, just to see what I mean. Play. So, as you can see, it's very jittery, and it's not really something we want. So, the thing is, this runs inside the same method that also moves him, and this runs inside update. So we're going to do a little change, and we're going to add this inside fixed update. So let's copy this, and yeah, well, first of all, we want to take the another delta, same way we have our delta, we're also going to have our fixed delta. And then fixed delta will be time dot fixed delta time. Then cut this and bring it here. Inside our handle local controller, we are going to be getting a few things that are not really necessary to be getting them inside fixed update. But for now, we can just leave them here. Just keep in mind that it's not really, it doesn't make much of a difference. I think, well, at least as far as the axes are concerned. I think for the two buttons, we can bring them inside update. And for that part, let's also bring them. Let's copy this and bring them above here. Aiming, shooting. So let's delete these two. Then with this we move. So that means handle recoil, handle aim down sounds, aim down sights, and shooting, and spread. So just go on to update now. Also, let's get these two buttons, although we're probably going to change them in the future. Okay, so now we split everything. So we're moving in fixed update, and everything else happens inside update, as it was before. So let's see what this is going to, the difference is going to make for us. Because the rigid body is moving inside fixed update. I think we forgot something. What? And it's trying to tilt. Why is this not mouse rotation by delta? Yeah, because we have delta. This will be fixed delta, because now we are inside, because this now runs inside fixed update, should be by fixed delta, not delta. Let's see, do we have anything else? I think we don't. Let's see inside our move direction. Let's fix this to be fixed delta by velocity down speed. Okay, that's probably fix it. This happened because on the first frame the delta was zero. Okay. Now we still get the same issue. I don't know why this suddenly decided that it doesn't have a base weapon. Doesn't make any sense. But let's see it. Base weapon. Well, how can you have the runtime weapon without your base weapon? Unless it's this guy. Yeah, he does have a runtime weapon. Remove it. Yeah, okay. So that's still off. And we still got the, god damn it. Weapon. So yeah, okay, let's fix those issues. I can see why current weapon doesn't actually is not being assigned, especially since we are doing this right on start. So let's take a look. Runtime weapon equipped, and this will assign you your current weapon. Current weapon and current weapon. So either this never runs, or we're doing something wrong. Maybe. Let's hit play. Can I weapon? It does have the your weapon, so that's stupid. Yeah, that's really stupid. Anyway, let's try find it out. You have your weapon, you have your this runtime weapon. Let's find the equip. Get weapon instance. So this is setting up. Yeah, okay, you do not set this up. Return value. Have your FPS prefab, you need it, which means you are assigning your base weapon. Magazine ammo, yeah, okay, this is not needed at the moment. And maybe from this. Yeah, I have no idea why this is happening at the moment. But let's see, let's put an if current weapon is not null inside handle recoil. What? Yeah, okay. Actually, it's not a, what? No, it's another reference. Debug.log. No current weapon. And it's done. But we still get, yeah, because we have your current weapon. Okay, so I don't know why it doesn't get assigned. We just saw that it does. So what is happening? Weapon one, weapon two. Let's ignore these two. Yeah, so something is bugged, as you can see. Because current weapon is assigned here. We literally see it. And this place as well. So maybe there is, oh. Damn, yeah. We have two controllers. Oops. Okay. So here's the thing. Then that means we, it wasn't an error actually that we had the controller. So let's bring it back. But because we moved it outside of the update, it means you still need to have is local. That's what we forgot. Yeah. Easy mistake to do. And it's very early in the morning. So hang on. Okay, so this will run on is local, but we still have the issue that the ADS does not come onto the correct position with us. So let's try and fix that via parroting. Or let's see if we can fix it via parroting. So here is our controller, here's our gun parent, here's our camera. Let's bring this inside our camera. And it still does nothing, but okay. So that's not it. Let's change this to this, and let's do public float lerp weapon or lerp ADS speed. Let's say 9. Let's see if the multiplication will fix it. And it doesn't. So that's weird that's actually happening like this. Pretty sure that will have fixed it. So let's say maybe if we've set it to 25. No, that still happens. So hold on. So yeah, the fix was easier and we do end up to have, you know, some more movement with this. So the fix was basically just taking this, moving the ADS inside fixed update and then changing the fixed delta to this. Okay. So with that, let's say we change this to 18, so this will be double the speed. We end up with something smooth that also gives us some small type of sway. Now, of course, when we aim downside, see, it goes like this, but when aiming downside, we are going to be moving slower. So let's find our speed above. We have our movement speed. Let's rename this to normal movement speed. And let's rename this to aim speed. Okay, we're also going to do a boost later. So let's find our handle local controller. Inside our move direction, if aiming, and I think, let's say, where do we apply the speed? Yeah, it's over here. So we'll start with float actual speed, normal movement speed. If aiming, actual speed will be aim speed. Okay, and then on your rigid body, you're going to be adding your actual speed. So that way, you're going to end up with less sway when you're moving. You should be having some at least. So normal movement speed, let's say it's 8, aim speed, let's say it's 3. Now, the other thing I want to add is we should go, just forgot what I want to do. Oh yeah, so when we're moving, we kind of want to lower our gun down. Okay, just to make it feel like there's an animation happening there. So we're moving, it's going to be slightly differently. So let's add public float, movement, down, weapon. Let's do -0.1f. So I'm going to go onto the base or to onto the target position actually, because movement down should be happening even when you're aiming. And then I'm going to say if move amount, which we do not have as a public variable, so let's actually go and add it as a class variable. Let's see. We want up down. Okay, yeah, we don't do anything with the as a move amount. Okay, so let's add it. We just want to know if we are moving. We don't really need any of that, so we could just say move amount equals horizontal plus vertical, but mathf.abs horizontal plus mathf.abs vertical, and all this clamped between 0 and 1. And that will be our move amount. Now, if move amount is not 0 or is higher than 0, or let's say 0.2f or 0.1f, just slight amount, I'm going to say on your target position, you're going to add the move down weapon. So let's hit play. Okay, so moving, yeah, 0.1 is too much. We can alter that. But you can see that it's going to change this. So let's go on the controller. Let's say 0.05. Let's make it 0.03, actually. Not 0.3. Okay, so now there is some movement at least. When moving, and maybe you can make this as a second variable as well, maybe for when aiming you don't want that much. And actually I think it will be too much for when aiming, so let's do and not aiming, which basically means you can just do an else here. Just so that you have some, at least, you have some specific, yeah, because there is already some movement with this. And I think we have the keys opposite for when torguing. So let's find our torque. And here's where it happens. And the torque is our pivot angle multiplied. So let's just make it the opposite. So now when I'm pressing E, I want to pivot on the right. Yeah. And when I'm pressing Q, I want to pivot on the other side. Now, I think we will benefit with some, you know, shaking when shooting. So we probably should add that as well. But what I want to add next is boosting. But let's do this on the next part. So this will be just the fixes. So as always, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, and if you like to see more stuff like this, more things, more of everything, then consider supporting me on Patreon so we can keep making all of these things. I'll see you next time.